Wouldn't it be funny if Dave muted and you could still hear the baby? You're like, duh. Hey, everybody. Welcome to a living room edition of Baseball Night in New York, brought to you by your Tri-State Cadillac dealers, Doug Williams, alongside Anthony Recker, Steve Gelbs, and Andy Martino, as we start a new week. Want to start this show tonight by talking about a guy. So let's talk about a guy, Yoenis Cespedes, somebody we really haven't discussed all that much since we've been doing the living room editions. And it's fascinating to examine exactly what this potentially shortened season might mean for him. We knew how much was on the line contractually for him in 2020. So we'll get to all of that. But Anthony, just to start off with, how much of a difference do you think a healthy Yoenis Cespedes, your former teammate, could mean to this 2020 Mets team as currently constituted?
Yeah, I mean, this guy, as far as a player goes and making big plays and big moments and everything, I mean, this guy is as good as it gets. He's loves that limelight. He loves the prime, you know, primetime lights, and he shows up and he does what he needs to do. You know, being with him in 12 in Oakland when he came over and seeing what he did, you know, that entire season, you know, big clutch plays and obviously hitting homers, the power, the speed, the ability in the outfield, the arm, everything. And then being in New York when he came there and just seeing the impact that he had on that team and what he was able to do in 15 and kind of carry them. I mean, this guy has incredible talent. He's got the ability to carry a team offensively for weeks at a time, you know, with big clutch hits and big, you know, power numbers and everything. So, I mean, this guy can bring so much to the table, big arm in the outfield, all this stuff. You know, it's huge. Now, he's getting a little bit older. I don't know if he has all that. He's coming off injuries. You know, we got to wait and see what he's got in the tank. But, I mean, as far as potential, this guy has the potential, a lot of potencia to be, you know, the guy for the Mets, you know, down the stretch.
Steve, you were able to see what goes into being Yoenis Cespedes, the work ethic that he has. For any Mets fans at home that may be doubting that or may have doubted that throughout his Mets tenure, what is it actually like in terms of his game preparation?
You know, hard for me to talk to precisely his game preparation. This is a guy that one of the most fascinating things about him during that 2015 season was that he really didn't take BP that often. And that was something that was talked about a lot, was that he wasn't taking any BP and then he'd go out there and hit a home run per night. What I can speak to, though, is the conversations that I've had with Mike Barwis actually a few years back about just how much of a beast he is in the gym. Barwis actually was pretty adamant about getting out the misconception that he was just a lazy worker behind the scenes. Barwis said that he was as intense a, you know, workout nut, I guess you could say, as there is. And that's why, you know, we saw some of the ridiculous things that we saw. Now, partially, and I know there was some criticism as well about how he worked out, you wonder if some of that bulking up contributed to some of the injuries during the course of his career. But in terms of getting him in the gym, how hard this guy works, according to Mike Barwis, who works with the elite of the elite of the elite, he was second to none in that regard.
And Andy, what I mentioned earlier about Cespedes and his contract, does he stand the game the most if we have a season and he performs well, or does he have a lot on the line here in terms of what ends up happening with this season? And if he's not able to perform, and not able to put up the numbers, he has the most to lose here.
I think he has his career to lose. I think most of us assumed for quite a while that he wasn't going to play baseball again. I still think we'll believe it when we see it, just because of how much time he's missed. Clearly, he's determined to pump our podcast through his earbuds and motivate himself to get back on that field.
What you're talking about to our audience? If you didn't see it, Cespedes produced and posted, I don't know if he produced it himself or his people did, but a video of him working out that is really about 70% Andy Martino's voice as motivation in the background.
But you know what I should say to that too? Like, yeah, he used some of my comments in that video, but I've never ever criticized him for work ethic, which is the direction this conversation was going a minute ago. I never heard anything that he wasn't a worker. It's really just like a weird presence that's very different in that clubhouse that Anthony and Steve have obviously both seen pieces of. I've seen and heard pieces of, but it's not work ethic. He's clearly motivated to get back out there. I'm talking more about stuff like there was a game in Atlanta a couple of years ago when they were either winning or losing in a blowout. Steve might remember, if it was,
I think they were winning.
They were winning, so they were up big. Yeah. Terry started taking guys off the field, as you do during a blowout, and Cespedes was really upset that Terry didn't take him out first. It's that kind of stuff. No one has ever called him lazy that I'm aware of, so I want to make that clear.
And by the way, the gist of what you were saying in the video was not even about that. It was about the fact that they re-signed him after the after the trade. So, and you were voicing your opinion. It was just about his ability as a player. And you know, the Mets have an abundance of position players if everybody's healthy. If you look at this lineup, they have plenty of outfielders. They want the glove of Mariznick in center, potentially. They have Nimmo. They have Conforto as well. J.D. Davis and Dom have to play somewhere every once in a while. So I'm curious, Steve, as you look at the roster, if Cespedes, the season starts, he's healthy, and he kind of defies what Andy's saying, is that he's somehow healthy and going to play again. Who loses the playing time if he gains it?
It's got to be J.D. Davis. He's the guy that stands the most to lose right now, because as currently constituted, if you penciled in an everyday lineup, I would say that J.D. Davis is playing left field more often than not. You're not sitting Conforto. Brandon Nimmo is the center fielder. J.D. Davis is not going to play center field for you. So if Yoenis Cespedes is healthy and capable of playing every day, then J.D. Davis is going to be the guy that stands to lose the most in that scenario.
Yeah, unfortunately, it is J.D. Davis. You know, you could throw Dom Smith in there a little bit too, because Cespedes isn't really – he's not really a guy who can split time with someone. He does about the same against lefties and righties. He actually has a higher average against righties in his career by about 20 points. OPSs are very similar. So I wouldn't say this is a guy that you want to, you know, have him hit lefties and Dom hit righties or anything like that. You know, it's just really – I think J.D. Davis is the one who would suffer. And just to backtrack quick on Martino, you know, what he was answering about the contract thing, he's a little bit older now anyway. I believe he's 35 now, or 34 going on 35. This is a guy who's not going to, you know, command like a huge contract anyway. So I don't think he has that much to lose. Yeah, he could get one more contract, 1 or 2 years, you know, at the most, maybe 2 years with, you know, some millions on there, obviously. But he's already made some money, so.
Okay, time now for out of left field. Interesting question here, and we'll start with you, Andy. Who is the most electrifying position player in Mets history? And it's no coincidence that we just came off a discussion of Yoenis Cespedes, who I think is definitely in this conversation. But your answer, go ahead.
Yeah, 2015 Cespedes in the conversation. For me personally, I have to go with what I've seen the most of, which is how electrifying Jose Reyes was at his peak. When that guy would leg out a triple at Shea Stadium during his early years, it was the single most exciting sight I've personally seen in baseball. It was like NBA-style athleticism and stuff that he could do, and the crowd would just go crazy.
Yeah, I'll not add too much more because I agree with Andy, but 2005 to 2008, Jose Reyes, 258 stolen bases, 65 triples. He averaged about 65 stolen bases per year over the course of four seasons. Just to put that in perspective, Acuna led the NL this year with 37. So he was electric. One of my best friends for about a decade was saying that Jose Reyes is the greatest baseball player that he has ever seen of all time, that there's no way anybody could be better than Jose Reyes. I don't know about that, but in his prime, he was as electric as they come.
I'm going to go back a little bit and say Daryl Strawberry. I mean, just the 8 years that this guy put together in a Met uniform, the homers, the stolen bases. You know, this guy hit 252 home runs in eight seasons as a Met. He also stole 191 bases as a Met. The only knock you could really give is he didn't play great defense in the outfield, but he wasn't terrible out there. I mean, and this guy, he lit up the entire city, the team. Like, I mean, he could carry them offensively. He did everything, and I mean, electrifying. This city could not stop talking about him during the years he was there.
I think Piazza's obviously in this conversation, but strictly for the home runs. And also, I think Cespedes is my answer because of the arm, because of the fact that, like Jose Reyes, watching Cespedes go first to third or leg out a double was also really cool in his prime. Such a good athlete. But always an interesting conversation to go through these Mets historical players. All right, everybody, if you're watching this online, you have to tune in to SNY at 7 o'clock to see the rest of the show. If you're watching on television, we'll see you after a short break.